Bonjour! Hi! Welcome in another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP, based in Montreal in Canada. And today, we continue to talk about the Azure Devtest Lab. I want to show you how to package it in the ARM template and deploying as you're creating your claimable VMs. Okay. So this is part 2 of a longer video. So if you don't know about Devtest Lab, you should go check my first part of the video. Well, the link will be here and also probably in the description. So we know the ARM template are fantastic to deploy. So it will be great to use it to deploy our Devtest Lab and create also our claimable VMs. In a Devtest Lab, we have the claimable VMs and we have also the formulas. One thing is, it will be great to create the claimables VMs based on the formulas. However, it's not possible directly from the ARM template. So this is the only way I found it how we could do it. So first, we need an ARM template to define our Azure Devtest Lab. To do it, you could start from scratch and build it, or you could just create it from the portal and then use the automation script to extract the JSON file. So you go on the portal, you create your Azure Devtest Lab, and then you click here in the automation script. And here you will have all your JSON file. So you copy paste that in your favorite text editor. You already know, for me, it will be Visual Studio Code. Voila. So now what you need to do is clean it. So following my 5 best practices, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, go check that video I did not long time ago about how you could clean very easily your ARM template. With the magic of internet, I already have one prepared for you. So here it is. Okay, so let me show you what I did. So of course, I minimized the parameters and I leverage the variables. In the first resources, we see we have our Devtest Lab. And one thing that is different that I had is this sub-resources here. When you export the template, this part was not there, so you need to add it. So in those resources, you will need to add a virtual network. You will need to add a schedule. So the schedule is very useful if you want, for example, all your VMs to turn off at 7 p.m. And then a notification channel, so your user could receive an email. So that's the last sub-resource inside our Devtest Lab. Then I add the virtual network and all the other resources were already present in the exported template. I just cleaned them. Now, what we need to do is declare a formula. So here it is, my formula. So formula is look very complex. So I invite you to go on the documentation and see. And a good way to start working on that is create a simple formula directly from the portal and then look at it. Unfortunately, when you will do an export of the ARM template, that formula will not be there. So a good way to see it, it's use the Resource Explorer. To get to the Resource Explorer, you go to resources.azure.com. And then you pick your lab, and you will see everything from it. And then inside the lab, you look for the formula. Here it is. You will see all your formula. So I create one here called Simple DevBox 2. And now I have all the properties that I need to look for. So you could copy paste that in your template. Let's have a look. This is my formula that I just create. So I put a description, an owner, it's a Windows. I want to create a DevBox for a Windows user, a small DevBox. So I specify the standard B2S as a user. I use it, my administrator will be Frank, and the password, I use a parameter. I use Key Vault for the password. I will show you that just in a few. Then we specify the network, the subnet. For the artifact, I only use right now two, Git and VS Code. Those are available in a public repository, but if you want to test your own source code, those will probably be in a private repository. You just need to declare that private repository, add it to the ARM template, and then you will be able to reference it. And then a little bit more specification about the VM itself. So here I use the Windows 10, something like that, and the network. That's it. So now, how could you reference a key vault value from an ARM template? A good way to do it is to make a reference. So here I was receiving it from a parameter. So I should have put a secure string, but I was just trying to trace, so I put it that way. If I check in my parameter file, I will see the admin password is here, and instead of putting the value, I will put reference and then key vault, and then I will put the full path of my key vault and then secret name to retrieve my password or my secret. That way it's very secure. So perfect. We have our ARM template. Now what we need to do? Of course, first we need to validate it. Be sure before waiting for minutes about creating it, just validate. Once your validation passed, it's now time to try it. So now if we deploy that, we will have a nice lab with the formula, but still no claimable. So a way to create claimable VMs is to use in Azure CLI the AZ lab VM create. That will be creating a VM. So we specify the lab, we want to push it, and then of course the resource group, the name of the machine, and the formula we want to use. Note that I don't need to pass any user or password because that's all defined inside my formula. That's great, but I would like to have a script that runs everything. Let me show you, I already have one example for you. Because I want to use Azure CLI, I create a bash file. So that bash file will receive three parameters. So the first one will be resource group name, the resource group location, and the key vault name. And then I specify the two, the template and the parameter file. Here I create a token. By the way, I will put a link to that file inside the description if you need it. All the code will be available there. And then, you know, if it's required, you could log in and specify a subscription. Here I will check if the resource group exists. If yes, I will use it. If not, I will create it. And then here, what I do is I do the same thing, but for the key vault, and then I will be populating the key vault, putting the password. So using a key vault is a very good way to secure information, so you could use them without knowing the value. Of course, for today, it's overkill because everybody should know the password since they will probably use it to connect remotely to the VM. But it was a great way to show you how to use Key Vault. Then I execute the command we know well, deployment. Then, because in my ARM template, to be sure that my resources have a unique name, I always add a suffix. So I don't know that suffix. Here, I go retrieve those values. And then I create my lab. So let's try that thing. Of course, you could have run everything in PowerShell, but I like to do my script in Azure CLI and Bash, so it could run also on a Linux machine. So Bash, the name of my script, and the three parameters. So let's run this, and I will get back to you just after. Well, so everything is done, the VM is available. If we check, I have my formula also that is available. Should see it, voila. I have my auto shutdown, everything is there. Perfect. So in one click, I generate my lab, my formulas, and then I create claimable VM based on those formula. One click. Awesome. So perfect. That way you could reproduce anytime, a full lab with everything done very smartly, and your VM will be consistent. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. To know more about Devtest Lab, you should check my other video just here, part 1. And to learn more about the best practices and clean your ARM template, you should check my other video just here. Thank you for watching. See you next time.